Good morning, good evening, and good afternoon. Today, my readers, is gonna be a fun one. I am going to be reviewing When the Mountains Roar. This book was written by Jess Butterworth. It is based on a girl who moves to India, and ever since her mom died, she is afraid of everything. She faces a lot of difficulties trying to fit in India since she is not from there. You know what, guys? Soon, in the mountains of India, the leopards are getting extinct. Ruby takes responsibility and investigates the source of this extinction. The book is full of adventures and emotions. It also has a really good way of explaining the beauty of the mountains and the animals. You just feel really good reading the book. The main characters of this book are Ruby, her dad, her grandma, Praveen, Mr. Butt and Mr. Anand, and Garjan Locker. Ruby is the main character of this book, as you might have guessed by now. Praveen is the person who introduces their hotel to them, and Ruby becomes fast friends with him. Mr. Bhatt and Mr. Anand are the two bosses of Ruby's dad, and Garjan Mankar is a famous actor who visits their hotel once. Throughout the story, Ruby's dad, Ruby herself, and her grandma face a lot of difficulties trying to fit in their old hotel since it's already occupied with scorpions and spiders and bears and who knows what. Then, one night in Holi, which is a festival held in India in which people throw paint at each other, a car zooms by them and suddenly Ruby has an awful memory. She's driving in her mom's car with her mom and they're having fun. A truck comes out of nowhere and hits them. Ruby just puts this awful thought out of her head and enjoys the rest of the night. But only one thing in her head remains till this day is that it was her fault that her mom died. Now that is something for you guys to uncover on how it was Ruby's fault. Later on, Ruby and Praveen go to the mountains and they spot some mysterious people. They realize that it was Mr. Bhatt, Mr. Anand, and Garjan Mankar, and they were the actual leopard poachers. And when she realizes that, she has to take action and she has a camera. Now, the rest of the story is for you guys to go buy the book and finish it. Now, I'm going to read my favorite pages from the book. Are these your goats? I ask. Yes, Praveen replies. I reach forward to stroke one. Hands off! You might scare them. I stop, taken aback. Dad pushes a stiff gate open. I hop onto the wall, pausing at the top and sighing. We really are in the middle of nowhere. Thick jungle and tall pine trees surround us on all sides, and beyond it rise mountains and snowy peaks. Grandma leads the donkeys with our luggage and Joey. Joey is the kangaroo they find halfway towards their cruise, which would take them to India. We walk through the neglected garden, overgrown with giant daisies, purple orchids, and orange lilies. Joey squirms in the pillowcase and I stop to adjust her. My arms ache. What's in there? Asks Praveen. Nothing, I reply. Is it a goat? No, it's a kangaroo, I say. I've never seen a kangaroo, says Praveen, eyes widening and stepping towards it. Hands off, I reply, mimicking him. You might scare her. I would rate this book a 4 out of a 5. Don't forget to go hit that subscribe button, smash the notification bell, comment, share, and like. Stay tuned because I'm going to be reviewing Quidditch Through the Ages. See you next time, my pals. Stay tuned because in my next video, I'm going to be reviewing When the Mountains Roared.
Abunda la caca!
Now I'm going to read a few of my favorite pages from the book. Thick jungle and tall pine trees surround us.
Abunda la caca!
The book is based on a girl who moves to India. Then, one night in Holi, which is a festival run...